Hello everyone, today we are going to discuss a question which comes to our mind whenever we go under stress. When we are under stress, we find that our body is behaving differently. At times we feel that we are sweating a lot, and at some other time we may find that our heartbeat, it has gone up or it has gone down. And sometimes we see a mix of these different things happening altogether. And after some time, when that stress is over or when we are little calm, then all these symptoms, they ease away or they fade away. So the question comes to our mind that why it happens so. Whenever we are doing some physical activity, so due to that physical activity, or whenever we are in disturbed mental state, that disturbed mental state may be due to maybe we are very happy or we are very sad or we are very angry. So these all situations, they create mental disturbance. Under these conditions, what we observe that there may be increase in the breathing rate. The number of times that you breathe in a minute, that is at normal stage, it is 72 times per minute. But when you are under stress, the breathing rate may become more or less. Similarly, your breathing also may get heavy. You take deep breath during the stress conditions. Another thing that you may observe is that there may be sweating. Why do we sweat? We sweat because the water content in the sweat, it gets evaporated, and that causes cooling of the body. So that means due to certain reason, body is trying to cool down itself. Another observation may be that your muscles may contract or they may get relaxed. How do you feel this? That you may feel muscular cramp in your belly, or you may find that your biceps or triceps muscles, they start twitching. You may feel pain in your legs, or you may feel that your legs have gone weak. So these are due to some change in the muscle activity. Another change that you may observe is that there may be increased heartbeat. Your heart starts beating faster, and the heart contraction, it becomes more forceful. Or you may feel that there is increased blood flow via blood vessels into your skin or in other parts of the body. You can very easily feel that your skin, it has either reddened or it has become pale. So sometimes it gets reddened when you are angry, then your face may become red. But when you are under the condition of fear, then the skin may look pale. So all these changes you may observe that when you are doing some physical activity or when you are doing disturbed mental state, you may be able to observe one or many or all of these symptoms appearing in your body. So the question comes to our mind that why it happens so, and why these all symptoms are so similar to each other when we are doing physical activity or when we are in disturbed mental state. And another very interesting observation is that when the physical exercise is stopped, then all these activities, they fade away gradually. Fade away gradually means that slowly you will feel that all these symptoms, they vanish and your body comes back to normal condition. So somehow it tells us that there is some link between doing physical activity or being in a disturbed mental state and showing of these symptoms. So what could be the reason why it happens so? So this we will be studying in today's lesson. And as we study this, what we will find that is applicable to all the conditions in which these symptoms, they may appear. Let us try to understand that how these symptoms appear. These symptoms, they are appearing in not only one organ, it may be appearing in many organs, maybe two or maybe more than two organs, they may be showing these symptoms. Now, the point is that why it is happening so. That means that there is some system in our body because of which the organs, they are able to interact with each other, they can communicate to each other, and their activities, they complement the functions of each other. That system which is regulating this process, by which the organs, they can integrate, and the entire organism, it acts like one unit, that is called as coordination. So what is coordination? Coordination is the process through which all organs of the body, they interact with each other and they complement the functions of each other. And what is the use of this? That due to this coordination, the whole body of the organism, it acts like a single unit. Now another question comes, that why it happens so? The reason for this is that we want to adjust with the environment. So that means when we are under stress or when we are doing some physical activity, then our internal or external environment is changing. When we are under stress or fear or anger or happiness or sadness, then our internal environment is changed due to our feelings. And when we are doing physical activity, then our external environment is changing. Or we can say that due to increase in temperature or sudden sound produced in the environment, these also changes, they may produce these symptoms. And now the second part of the question was that how come our body return back to the normal situation? That happens because of body's capability to maintain its normal condition. So that normal condition in which the body wants to be, that is called as the homeostasis. So what is homeostasis? Homeostasis is the ability or tendency of the body to maintain internal stability of the organism. There are certain conditions at which our body functions very well. So the body wants to maintain those conditions at which all the systems can work very well. And whenever there is a change in that environment, then that situation, when there is change, due to that, some emergency condition is created. And when there is emergency condition, body tries to return back to the normal situation. So that happens because of the capability of the body to maintain normal conditions, which is called as homeostasis. Let us take an example to understand it further. Let us assume that you are happy over something. After some time, you will see that you become normal. What happens that if you are happy or you are angry or you are sad or you are afraid, you cannot remain in this situation for the remaining part of the life. You will return back to normal situation. The same thing may be happening with the negative emotion. For example, fear. For example, there may be some reason because of which you are upset. So under that situation also, you will tend to return to your normal situation. So this normal situation is maintained, and that is maintained by homeostasis. So as we have understood that homeostasis in case of human beings, that is a dynamic state. Let us try to understand that what is this dynamic state. That means that homeostasis is not some fixed state, because whenever there will be change in environment, let it be internal or external, then body will try to adjust with the change and new homeostasis state will be reached. And when that emergency is over, then the body will try to maintain it to the new situation. So that is why it is called as that homeostasis in all human beings or all living organism, it is a dynamic equilibrium. And this dynamic equilibrium, it is maintained through the feedback that we get from our hormones or which we get from our senses. So this is how our body is preparing itself to meet all the emergency situation. When that emergency situation is over, body reaches the situation where it can come back to the normal situation. So I hope I have made this explanation clear. If there is any question, you can further ask.